Hey kids, let's talk about school. There are a few life things, or a couple academic things that I remember that really have helped me in life, have helped me transition into going back to school again, and just overall getting better grades in my classes. The first most important thing I learned was how to write pretty much in general. Everyone has to take English 101, which is a writing course. My class was probably on the easier side because my mom took a 101 class and she had to write like 2 papers a week, which is crazy. And in my class, I only had to write a couple papers here and there. One was about a personal experience or something about my life. I can't exactly remember. My final paper was actually on this book, so it was cool because I got to read a book on top of having a writing course. Like, it wasn't just strictly writing. I also got to read a book, which probably a lot of people didn't want to do, but the book was really good. It was Sarah's Key, and it's also a movie. I don't know. Anyway, this isn't about the book. The writing aspect of it that I retained was how to write a good story. And that would include adding as many details as possible. Naming your characters, naming the place they live, describing everything. I mean, you don't want to go too crazy, but at the same time, you don't want to be completely vague, because then, I mean, sometimes it's nice because it leaves more up to the imagination, but if you want to write like solid piece, you know what I'm saying, then you want to add as many details as possible. I learned a lot of like grammatical things that I just remembered. It's really good that I learned all of this and that I kept it, because right now in my university, I'm taking a level 300 literature class, and in the beginning of the class today, he took like 20 minutes just to go over the mistakes that students make in their papers, and all of these mistakes I already knew not to make from my English 101 class at my community college. So I was like, this is crazy. My writing course from 4 years ago still helps me write a good piece. The other thing I learned from community college was that you have to get involved, and that's something that I kind of did, but not really. I mean, I joined the choir and I was in the honor society. I did the a cappella group. I think that the problem with community college is that people kind of just go because they have to, because they're fresh out of high school and they don't really know what else to do with themselves. Or there are a lot of adults going back to school because they didn't go to school when they were younger, so now they have families and full-time jobs and they're just back at school, you know, just trying to get an education so they can get a better job. You kind of don't have the sense of community. You don't have the sense of being proud of where you go. I mean, the university that I go to now, everyone is wearing the attire and they have like the water bottles, and I saw some girl with a laptop case with my school's like lettering on it, you know, and people wear like the hats and the sweatshirts and everything. At the community college I went to, people didn't wear the community college things. Like, sometimes you would see that I have a sweater from there. Most of the time people wore things from other colleges. It's smart to go to community college. So many people I met there had actually gone away for the first year, 2 years of their college education and decided that it was too expensive. They didn't like the dorm life. They couldn't handle being around all of that party scene and everything. They were homesick, but mostly it was just too expensive. And they all decided to just come back to community college anyway. So when you go to community college, you're pretty much skipping the step of being like an awkward, crazy freshman somewhere where you're just spending a lot of money and you don't, you know, you have this expensive meal plan, you're stuck in a dorm, you're not allowed to bring your car, so you're like literally stuck there. I mean, I can't even imagine. The good thing about going to community college is you get to live at home. Woohoo! You don't get to leave your bed, you don't have to pack up your room, you have your entire closet there, you have everything. Yay. Another really great reason to begin at community college is it's a really nice transition into school, because college isn't easy. High school is easy. College, not so much. I mean, I guess if you just be a good pupil, then you'll do well and you'll find it easy. It's just, it's a lot of work. It's a lot of effort you have to put into it. It obviously shows in your grades, and if you're doing what you're supposed to be doing, you're gonna get good grades, and that's a good feeling. So if you do well, you'll get into a better university like that, and you'll be more prepared for that university. If I went straight from high school to the school I go to now, I don't know how that would have gone. Let's just put it that way. It really prepared me for university, and especially that I waited 1.5 years to go from community college to university. Not only do I have the academic experience, I also have the experience of being more of an adult and knowing what my life is like without school, because I kind of just took advantage of the fact that, you know, I went right to community college. I was just like, yeah, I'm here to just hang out, get a degree, do my liberal arts then when the reality hit that I couldn't go to university, I was kind of like, well, what am I going to do now? And I worked a full-time job, and that's when it hit me, like, I can't do this. The reason I got into the university that I got into is because I went to community college. I got really good grades. I graduated with 3.5. You need all of those things to get into a better school. So if you're in high school right now and you're not doing so well, go to community college and, like, try. First of all, they don't even look at high school, pretty much. Join the Honor Society, Phi Theta Kappa. It's a honor society that's nationwide for all community colleges. If you're in community college and you have a 3.5, you can join Phi Theta Kappa. It's $75 to get in, and you have to just maintain a 3.0. You need a 3.5 to get in, but you only need to maintain a 3.0. You know, when it comes to the actual graduation, you get to, I mean, if you want to buy all of the extra things, which I totally did because I'm a sucker for this kind of shit, but you get, like, a gold tassel, you get a gold sash, you get, like, a gold rope to wear, you know, so it's really cool. You get a pin, whatever. Another great thing about joining Phi Theta Kappa is that they actually offer tons and tons of scholarships. I got a credit from my university of over $600, and I think it was just because I was in Phi Theta Kappa. They see that you are doing well in your community college, that you're putting in the effort, that you've joined the Honor Society, so they know that you're not just bullshitting through community college, you're actually taking it seriously, you're taking your grades there seriously, and that's something that a university obviously loves. That's what they're looking for serious students. If you're like me and you don't really adapt to change too well, community college is the thing for you. Yeah, it was just a great experience all around. My major was liberal arts, so I got to take so many different classes. I took a creative writing class, I took a biology class, I took astronomy, different kinds of history classes, I took three psychology classes. Yeah, I took a philosophy class, which I actually despised so much. I hated that class, and it's the only class I got a C in, so that's that. Say, go for it! I'm an advocate for community college. I've done enough rambling about community college. As we say from Phi Theta Kappa, commit to complete.